Hello and welcome to the 16th lecture in this lecture series introducing international investment law. In the last lecture, we discussed about fair and equitable treatment standard and how it was used in the India-UAE BIT and Brazil-India BIT. In this lecture, we will discuss the preliminary aspects of the FET standard, including its brief history and its nature and function. Now, as regards the history of FET standards, one of the earliest reference to these clauses is the Havana Charter for an International Trade Organization of 1948. Article 29, which dealt with the state treatment provided in Subarticle 2, with respect to such imports and with respect to the laws, regulations and requirements referred to in Para 8A of Article 18, each member shall accord to the trade of the other members fair and equitable treatment. Article 11, Subarticle 2 and Article 72 of the Charter contained extension of just and equitable treatment to foreign nationals and enterprises as one of the chief aims of the Charter. Another early reference to the FET standard is the Treaties on Friendship, Commerce and Navigation, FCN treaties, entered into between US and other countries. Article 17, Subarticle 2 of the FCN treaty between USA and Nicaragua of 1956 provided, each party shall accord to the nationals, companies and commerce of the other party fair and equitable treatment as compared with that accorded to the nationals, companies and commerce of any third country with respect to a. governmental purchase of supplies, b. awarding of concessions and other government contracts, and c. the sale of any service sold by the government or by any monopoly or agency granted exclusive or special privileges. We are not discussing these things in a detailed manner because the purpose of this current discussion is to highlight that FET clauses have been used historically and are not of recent origin. From these multilateral conventions and treaties, and also to an extent bilateral treaties, the FET standard was incorporated perhaps for the first time in bilateral investment treaties as they are known in the modern sense of the term, in the Switzerland-Tunisia BIT of 1961. The BIT is in French and so we won't quote the clause here. Though is interested and know French may kindly access the link provided in the references which are listed out in the description to this video. The next question we address is there one FET clause or are there many FET clauses and consequently are we generalizing it more than what we should? Academic commentary suggests that generalization of FET standard may not be the correct approach, although the purpose of the FET clause is to address a variety of governmental actions which affect investments and specific rules to counter such actions may not be suitable. Some treaties simply use fair and equitable treatment, while some treaties temper it with principles of international law. The clause finds its place on a standalone basis and in some cases along with full protection and security clause or the national treatment and the most favored nation clauses. As we saw in the Brazil-India BIT in the last lecture, exhaustive list of elements of the FET standards are also prescribed in certain new generation treaties. So, caution should be exercised while generalizing it and it is better to have a look at the treaty language for the FET standard. The FET standard reflects the practice of civil law courts where specific rules set forth are complemented by a general clause on good faith as an overarching principle which informs those specific clauses. So, what exactly is the nature and function of fair and equitable standard? Excluding the word and, fair and equitable are two terms. But are they different concepts? Commentary suggests that these are not two different concepts and represents a single standard. FET standard does not depend on the nations or the host states' laws unless the treaty language states so, of course. And there might be considerable overlap with other standards such as full protection and security, national treatment, and so on. Some of the situations identified in case law as violating the FET standard are the following. Lack of respect for the obligation of vigilance and protection. Denial of due process or denial of justice. Notably, several tribunals cited the lack of judicial or procedural propriety as evidence of fair and equitable treatment violation. Non-observance or frustration of investors' legitimate expectations. Coercion and harassment by the organs of a host state. Failure to offer a stable and predictable legal framework. Unjust enrichment. Evidence of bad faith. Note that many tribunals have held bad faith is not required for establishing the violation of FET. Absence of transparency. Arbitrary and discriminatory treatment. More on the FET standard in the next lecture. Stay safe. Bye-bye.